Mike Boccetti is Mrs. Goutfire. Here we go.
Oh.
He can't get out the door. Mike can't open the door.
It's hello! True.
Mike?
Hello, can't somebody be a gentleman around here and open the door for the lady? Which one, you blankers?
Blankers?
Blankers.
You wankers. Nice. I'm trying to be nice. This is Arthur's show, and I don't want to ruin it on him. Ah, oh, my gout is like, it's killing me, Arthur, because... Hello, Johnny, how are you? I'm a big fan of the...
There you go. There you go.
It's Mrs. Goutfire.
You've got your cream and your sugar
this
now.
This darn foot is killing me, Arthur.
How is your gout, Mrs. Goutfire?
It's not that good because it's bloody killing me, my back and my boobage, Arthur, because...
Your breasts look amazing. Is it cold?
Boobage?
Arthur, maybe we can have a cup of tea and share them later on, Arthur, because they're available on, you know, Mr. Doubtfire's not home right now, and I feel like having a little romp in the hay.
Oh.
You do?
Oh, no.
You feel like cheating on Mr. Goutfire?
Well, he's a weenie, Arthur, because he's a real wanker himself. I don't know why I even hooked up with that character, that imbecile, Arthur, because...
You're breathing out of control.
No, no.
You've got your cream and your sugar now.
I'm quite fine, Arthur, thank you.
Hey, where are your shoes, Mrs. Goutfire?
Is the gout so painful you can't wear shoes?
No, I actually lost them in a card game on the way over here, Arthur, because...
Really?
Yes, I, you know...
What? How did that happen?
I didn't play Pinochle as good as I thought I could, Arthur, and, you know, it's...
Pinochle?
Yes, and, you know, that game where we, you know, throw some money in and everybody has a jolly old time, and then usually a punch and fight breaks out, and, you know...
Were you just in a fight?
No, no, no. Only among family and friends, Arthur. We keep it, you know, like the Crown does. They keep it, you know, inside the family, you know.
Are you running out of English references?
No, 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 no.
Are you too out of
Never.
Breath to do the accent?
No, I love it, Jonathan, because, Jonathan, I'm a huge Raider fan because you were an amazing man because, you know, how about some tea and crumpets one time, Johnny? We'll have a good time.
Oh, there you go.
You've got your cream and your sugar now.
Actually, I have a crush on Mr. Dan Filato because he's,
Is that true?
Oh.
Oh, yes, 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 because he loves Mrs., you know, he loves me. I know Danny does.
What's your name? Did you forget your name?
I'm gobsmacked.
Daniel loves me. He actually picked out these clothes for me today. They're designed by Daniel, actually, because he's quite a good chap, and I have a heart for Danny. And
would you like
nice.
To roll on him in the hay?
Oh, yes, we'll roll on a good one, because...
Now, do you have an analysis of the Super Bowl, Mrs. Goutfire?
I'm quite disappointed in the game. It was a fiasco, because they should have just played another time, and it was horrid.
There you go.
They got wiped.
What are you saying?
It was horrible.
Why should they have played another time?
It was brutal, Art. It was like when the, you know, the colonists fought us a long time ago, Art. It was brutal.
When the colonists fought
yes,
you?
Yes, you know, that fake fight we had with you guys a long time ago. You know, a little skirmish that you claim you won, but you never did.
Well, no, we definitely won. I mean, we got our
freedom. No, that's all rubbish.
Are you still fighting
we're
that war?
We're a different country now.
Yeah.
What country? No, no, we still, you know.
You still own America?
In our own brain, we do, Jonathan. Yes, okay. We do. We never left.
Well, I mean, you know, I knew your improv is brilliant. The improvisational act.
Hello, I have a crush on him. And where's the big camera guy? He's a good guy, too.
Josh?
Yes.
He's behind you.
Oh, nice. Hello, Josh, because... I like quite the strong, silent type.
You want to shag him?
He's a guy from the country in Ohio. He's such a gentleman. And where's
Don't ruin your purse.
No. No, no.
What's in your purse?
A lot of good things, Johnny. Come on and come on over and see what's inside.
He slipped into Staten Island. A lot of good things.
A lot of great things, Johnny. You want to come over and check my purse, John? Because
don't
have a good old time with
it. Remember, you have the gout and your English.
The gout. It's
yeah, why is Mrs. Goutfire oversexed? This is
Mrs. Goutfire needs a good
out
one.
Out of character.
Does Mrs. Goutfire need a good? She needs a good shagging.
Mrs. Goutfire needs a good shagging for the next four or five days, Arthur. You know, I'm happy to be on the show, and because you know you're a big star, and so is John, and I'm happy to be here with you guys.
Bang me.
Well, I mean, it's a sports show technically. You don't have any other analysis of the Super Bowl?
No, I know a little bit about cricket and polo and that kind of stuff, but no.
Cricket and polo?
Yes, you know, the good games. Soccer is huge, still where we are.
Yeah, soccer. Who's your favorite soccer player?
I'm an old timer with that. Pele was great. He tried to bring it over here to America, but it failed, of course. Because you guys couldn't get the game. That's the thing, because we're very sophisticated out there, and you guys just haven't learned from us.
Interesting. Well, Mrs. Goutfire, listen, everybody I think is going to love you.
Oh, thank you, Arthur, because...
Because? Well, now, why are you saying because?
You would think, being a Brit, that David Beckham would have been her...
Yeah, what about Beckham?
Oh, Mr. Beckham, he's a good friend, Danny. We tossed a few cocktails together and wrote a couple of novels. You know, they were good.
You wrote a couple of novels with David Beckham? In
3 or 4 nights, so it was pretty fast.
How's his Willie?
Hello? Excuse me, Don, would you say? There you
go. How's his Willie?
Why did that question come to mind?
Oh, it's a nice one.
For you.
Now, do you have bronchitis still?
No, bronchitis is... I only have the gout, Arthur, because that came off the Mayflower, and, you know, it lingered on here forever.
Yeah, well, I mean, not a lot of people in the modern world have it. You have.
Yeah, it's in my ancestry, Arthur, because it came off the Mayflower, that John Smith, whatever that
Captain
name
John,
was.
Captain
yes,
John
Smith?
Yes,
that's right.
Smith?
He hit on my great-great-grandmother. He was a pervert, Arthur, because he gave her the gout.
I mean, did your great-great-grandmother look like you?
He gave her the gout?
He gave it a gout because
the gout is a sexually transmitted disease.
Oh, yes. He gave it a gout because
did he have sex with her foot?
No. Yeah, what happened was they were one night they were behind the barn and you know
behind the barn.
Yes, and you know
what a masher.
Yes, and you know it was kind of improper at the time. You know, she was butt naked and he was just having a good time and you know and some of the townspeople caught them and you know they threw some rocks at her for a while and they forgave her.
All right. Well, Mrs. Goutfire is right. No one knows what he's talking about. Mrs. Goutfire is going to be here all night. Can we have the twins out here?
Arthur, because I love the twins. They're adorable, Arthur.
Where now, do you like the twins? I know Mike Boccetti likes the twins, but do you, Mrs. Goutfire,
do you feel threatened
by them?
No, they're charming young women. They come from the crown, too, I think.
Yeah.
Well, the fact that they're...
Hey, Marie.
Hello.
I love that. It's so nice.
Thank you. I love the stain on your shirt.
Oh, nice. I put it there today.
What is that? What is the stain on your shirt?
Oh, it was beef burgundy, Arthur. It just came off.
Now, do you have a catheter in right now?
No. This might be Baked Alaska, Arthur. I'm not sure.
Baked Alaska?
Wouldn't that be Beef Wellington?
Beef Wellington.
Hello. Hello, Liz.
Baked Alaska.
You're nice, too, because you guys are so charming. Don't let these ruffians fool you and get any crap.
No, do you
take them and slap them once you and just give them a good one.
Do you feel threatened, Mrs. Goutfire?
No.
That they're young and beautiful and you're older and disgusting?
No, because I was just giving the girls a good lesson example because people like to bully them, and it's not right. They should take this and just go bang to anybody
like
that gives them one. Right, Marie? You don't take any crap. Liz is great. Liz is very laid back.
Thank
you.
This is very surreal.
Take this and go.
Good idea,
you know what?
Mrs. Goutfire.
How about you just hit them between the nuts with this, too? That would be a better one if
Perfect
they get really
idea.
Out of hand.
No one here has nuts.
The girls really look like they get into the show. They look like they have the flu around Thanksgiving.
No. You can't.
I know, I just said I didn't put any nuts.
Quite astonishing.
I'm beautiful no matter what.
Yes, you are. That's right, because us women have to stick together. That's right. Let's go over and give them a good one, girls. Come on. Let's
a good one what?
A good shellacking. Come on.
You look like one of the suffragettes.
Yeah.
They women are bullied too much.
Like
women's
Bush.
Rights, ladies. Let's get them.
Go
and give them a good one. Take my purse.
You look like Barbara Bush.
Can we bring up a picture of Barbara Bush?
You look exactly like Barbara Bush.
I'm not a drunk.
Oh, what?
I'm not a drunk. I don't frolic in public and carry on.
Stop saying that.
What are you talking about?
No. That's Betty Ford. I'm sorry. Wrong
no,
president.
That's the Betty Ford Center.
Oh, God.
No, that's the... Yeah, that's the Addiction Center.
Wrong president. I'm sorry for picking the wrong
thing. Mrs. Gaffar, 1 second. I have to tell the girls. So, girls, you have an assignment this month.
Okay. Yes.
I'm going to explain it. So, it's Black History Month. So, in honor of that, starting tomorrow night, you girls have to pick a black person, living or dead, and explain why you like them and why they're good.
Okay? All right.
Liz, are you up for this?
Sure.
So tomorrow night, in the first segment, we're going to start this. So you have a whole day to think about one black person and living or dead and why you think they're good.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right? And Liz?
Yes?
You guys, you know, you're going to have to do it together. So, you know, one person can't not
Elaborate.
Say anything. Yeah.
Two different people. Why don't we each pick our own?
You want to do that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
And so the black people rose up.
Well, they're very individuals. They do quite a great job on their own. They don't need any help because they're super smart and charming. They can.
Well, Mrs. Goutfire, you've said before that you like their curly hair, the black women.
Oh, they're nice people, too. I love everybody, Arthur, because I just don't like pinheads and haters on Twitter and things like that.
Hey, Artie, didn't you say that we have a request for the audience, too, to send in some letters for...
Yeah, we're going to...
Deerdorf Abbey.
We're going to do a bit called Deerdorf Abbey, where Dan Deerdorf gives relationship advice.
Arthur, can you please change things with the ladies?
So we need some letters.
They're so nice, and people taunt them all the time, and it's not right. And just, like, step the game up and treat them with respect, and because womankind is amazing.
Wow, Mrs. Goutfire, you're so nice.
Where'd that come from?
From Mrs. Goutfire, Arthur. Why are you making me walk? Don't be a gentleman, Arthur, please, because
you've got your cream and your sugar.
He's got to carry away. Look at that skirt.
All right, sit down.
Now, who's on the show tonight, Mrs. Goutfire?
Skirt is slimming.
Oh, it's a jolly good one, Arthur, because tonight, joining us in studio, acting comedian, the great LaBelle Crawford. He was on Last Comic Standing. He's quite an amazing man. He's funny, Arthur.
Okay.
Dropping by in the second hour, comedian, this gentleman's been here before, Arthur. He opens for Mr. Billy Burr, Jason Lawford. Jason Lawford, Arthur. That's right, like Law.
It's not Jason Lawford.
Like Harvard, Arthur. Like
oh, my God. You look exactly like Barbara Bush.
Really?
Oh, my.
Yeah, look at her.
Wow.
Oh, wow.
Wait a minute, Arthur. It could be Arthur because, you know what?
That's startling.
Arthur, you know what, Arthur? It could be. Part of my family is from Texas. It might be true because...
Part of your family's from Texas?
Yes, that's right. We came from the Crown and went to, you know, Austin right away and, you know, Houston and Fort Worth and places like that, Arthur. We did.
He's yelling out Texas City. Go ahead.
And calling in the top hour from... Sochi, Russia, sportscaster the great Kenny Albert. No. How dare you? No. Don't do that to a lady, Mr. James, because give the lady the benefit of the doubt. Don't be a schmuck. Don't be a wanker. Let me finish my thing.
He's coming at you, James.
Yeah. Go ahead, try it.
Boy, that skirt starts when that skirt starts riding up, it is really scary.
No, Arthur.
The
lady's all right. James is a bully. He likes to pick on Mike with that buzzer, whatever it is. Let Mrs. Doubtfire finish. It's not nice to ridicule a lady, James. Please
shut
nice.
Up and finish then.
All right, calling at the top of the hour from Sochi, Russia, sportscaster the great Kenny Albert. Kenneth Albert. No, that's right. Don't give me.
But you said the city wrong, I think, right?
Yeah.
It's in Russia. I don't know much about them.
But what's the city? It's been all over the news.
Sochi, Russia. I don't know, Arthur, because I'm not from that part of the world, because the Russians and the Brits never had any beefs. I don't know what the thing is.
You're not from Moscow. You get that name right.
Moscow's simple, Arthur, because, you know, it's one of the main ones.
This isn't that hard.
Just sound it out.
I don't know, John, because I'm not an English major, because I tried, but, you know.
Well, you tried to say Sochi.
Yes, that's it, John. Thank you, buddy.
That's not it. That's what you said.
Ladies, please, someone help a lady out here. Mrs. Doubtfire.
The ladies can't help. The ladies can't help you.
Try it a different way.
Oh, thank you. I didn't hear anything.
It's going to be a big month for the girls because on top of the Black History Month, they're going to be giving reports on what's going on over there for the Olympics.
Yes.
Well, are you girls fans of the Olympics?
Yes. We just watched a whole thing on some of the Olympians today.
Really?
Introducing us to them.
How'd that go?
Great. There's some really amazing stories.
Well, like what? Give me one. Give a tease.
A girl with no legs is going to be a snowboarder.
Well, that's ridiculous.
In the snowboard. No! How is that ridiculous?
Because she shouldn't be there.
What? Arnie, why would you say that?
She got
bacterial meningitis, lost both her legs, and now she's going to be...
That means you can't be in the Olympics. It's one of the sacrifices when you lose your legs.
No, I think it's a great story.
When you lose your legs to a horrible disease,
yes.
One of the things, unfortunately, you can't be in the Olympics.
Well,
the
no.
Why not just let me in?
Wouldn't it be harder?
Not right. That's go for the underdog. And
let me run the marathon, then, or the decathlon.
What
if you have the gout? Are you excluded from the Olympics?
What? No, it's not that Mike.
It sounds like an unfair advantage if you don't have legs. You can't really fall off as easily, right?
Yeah.
I don't know. They didn't go into that.
What, did they give her those fake legs?
Yes.
Well, that's not fair.
She's got bionic legs.
Yes, she does.
Good, Arthur. She went through a lot of stuff. Let the lady live and have peace, Arthur, and she's going to win because, you know, it's right.
How do you know she's going to win?
Because I love the underdog, Arthur. It's always right. Mrs. Doubtfire loves the underdog.
Try to get the name right again.
John, be a gentleman and say the name, please. No, no.
What's the name of the Russian city?
Someplace in Russia, Arthur. I'm not really sure. If it's
there you go.
Oh, Mike, just try to say it differently
than
I'm you
just did.
No, I'm
not Mike, John. Stop
it's
it
Mrs. Goutfire.
All you got to do is sound it out. It's pretty
John,
phonetic.
You know, I'm not good at Russian names because they're nice people, but I just don't know how to say it right.
Try it.
Okay, Arthur, sorry. I'm
don't
be
a
quitter, Mr. Goutfire.
And FYI, Barbara Bush was a New Yorker and then Andover, me.
No.
Are we going to start going over his mistakes now?
No, the Bushes are from Texas. No. Look at that cowboy hat he has on.
Yeah,
in Dallas.
No,
I think
they
you need some fake legs.
Yeah. Maybe now my gout, Arthur, please, can you get a massage up here? I need one quick.
Oh, that's gross.
No.
Try one more time to say the proper name, because we got to go.
I'm not sure, Arthur. I'm sorry. It's...
Say it!
Sochi, Russia, I guess. That's it.
Yeah, you got it right!
Please give Mrs. Goutfire the benefit of that, Arthur.
Because
Goutfire.
Goutfire, Arthur, gout.
888-936.
It's MRS, Goutfire, Arthur, Goutfire.
888-936-8822. 888-936-8822. It's going to be a fun night. Lavelle Crawford is here, and we'll be talking to him after this. Mrs. Goutfire here all night.
The Artie Lange Show, weeknights on Audience, only on DirecTV.